Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is the introduction to dividing by decimals. Let me show you the method, and we do these three problems on this video. So we have a division problem here where we are dividing by a decimal. It's not a whole number. So far, we've only gone over how to divide by whole numbers, right? So what do you do if this is a decimal? So first of all, what does this really mean, 25.74 divided by 1.1? It means 25.74 over 1.1 is a fraction. That means the same thing. So the question is, how can I make this a whole number in the denominator? Can I multiply the denominator by something to make it a whole number? And the trick is, if you could move the decimal 1 point to the right, you'd have a whole number, 11. So when you're dealing with fractions, you can multiply the numerator and denominator by the same thing. So if I multiply the numerator and denominator by 10, essentially I get to move the decimal in the numerator one to the right. So that's, whoops, 257.4, and in the denominator I get to move it one to the right, and now you have a division problem where you're dividing by a whole number, which we know how to do. So then we do 11 into 257.4. Alright, so now how do we do this? You put the decimal up here, right? You got to make sure there's a whole number. That's how you know where to put the decimal. And then we go ahead and do our regular division. So 11 into 25 goes twice. Bring down the next digit. 11 into 37 goes three times. And bring down the next digit. 11 into 44 goes four times. And a remainder. So this actually has an answer of 23. Okay, let's check the answer. To check, you take your answer times the 1.1 and make sure you get back to 25.74. You want to go back to the original problem when you check. So the question is, what is 23.4 times 1.1? And you could use any method you want for multiplying. You could use the lattice method, or you could do regular multiplication. You can get out a calculator, but you need to multiply this out, and you get 25.74, and that's the answer. So I'm not going to do the multiplication on this video because we're concentrating on division and how are we going to divide if this number over here is a decimal. All right, let's look at another problem. Let's try this one. So we have the same problem. We're dividing by a decimal. So if we take what that means, what does this mean? 0.212 divided by 0.08. We could write it as a fraction first. And then how could I make this a whole number in the denominator? You can multiply it by not 10 because that would move it over one place, but you can multiply it by 100. So you have to multiply numerator and denominator by the same thing. So in the numerator, if you multiply by 100, it moves a decimal 2 to the right, so that's 21.2. And in the denominator, it moves it 2 to the right, that's 8. And now we could do the division. We're dividing by a whole number. So let's do that. 8 into 21.2. The decimal will then go up here because we're dividing by a whole number. All right, so we have 8 into 21, that goes twice. And subtract, bring down the next digit. Okay, 8 into 52, that goes 6. 6 times 8 is 48, and subtract. Okay, now I need to append a 0 here at the end so I can bring down another digit. 8 goes into 45 times. And I'm done. No remainder. So that means 0.212 212 divided by 0.08 is 2.65. Which we could check. So you want to take our answer times what we divided by and see if that's what we get. So what you do is do 2.65 times 0.08 using any method you want for multiplying, calculator, lattice method, regular multiplication, and you will get 0.212. So that's the exact answer. Let's look at this first problem again. The first problem was 25.74 divided by 1.1. And remember what we did, we wrote that as 25.74 over 1.1 and we multiplied by 10 over 10 and we ended up with 257.4 over 11. All right, let's say the problem was given to you in this format. So you see the 1.1 out in front and the 25.74. Here's the shortcut method. If you multiplied both the numerator and denominator by 10, that's the same thing as taking the number on the outside in front of the division and inside and multiplying it by 10, which means move the decimal one to the right. So what you could do if it's in this format already, this is the shortcut, you just move the decimal one to the right, and your answer is going to have the decimal point right here. So as opposed to writing it as a fraction, multiplying by 10 over 10, and then coming up with a problem. So this is what it looks like, and then you proceed, and it kind of confuses some people, but you just have to ignore the decimals and know that the final answer for your decimal is going to be right here. So let's do this quickly again. You multiply by 2, 11 into 25 goes 2. 11 into 37 goes 3. Bring that down. Bring down the 4. And same exact answer, you're going to get 23.4. So the reason you could just move your decimal one to the right is because you're multiplying the numerator and the denominator by 10. To get so that you're dividing by a whole number. So that's the shortcut, and especially if it's already given in that form. Let's do that on the second problem. So this was the problem, 0.212 divided by 0.0, but let's say that you know you're opening up some problems and it was in this format already. You know, like if you open up a math book, it might look like that. So you could go back and rewrite it like I've written up at the top, but again, the shortcut method is you want a whole number. You always want to divide by whole numbers, so you have to move this two spaces to the right, which means you're multiplying by 100, and so that means you have to do the same thing with the number under here. Multiply it two spaces to the right, and that's where the new decimal point goes. Right? And then you go ahead and divide just like we did in the previous problem, and check just like we did in the previous problem. So let's do that quickly. We're going to do 8 into 21 goes twice. Bring down the 2. 8 goes into 52 six times. And then what do you have to do? You have to put another 0 here. So you could bring that down. 8 into 40 goes 5. So we're still going to get the same answer of 265. You have to be comfortable doing it in this form, or if you're given it in this form and you have to write it down as a write the division sign. Personally, I think it's easier if it's in this top form that you go ahead and move your decimal points right here, and then when you write the problem, it looks a little less messy. You'll just write 8, right? Because imagine the decimal point is now there. So you just write 8 into 21.2. It's a little bit less messy than, you know, seeing all these little lines I'm drawing here. But in any case, when all is said and done, the answer is still going to be 2.65. All right, let's try this problem. So now notice I'm giving it to you in this format, 0.75 into 2.4. So you need to move the decimal 2 to the right, so you're dividing by a whole number. So what do you do here? When you move it 2 to the right, you're going to have to put in a 0 right here. And the decimal point then will go right up there. And I don't know if we're going to have to put some extra zeros or not, so let's go ahead and just see what happens if we divide. So now you have to think, if this is 75 into 240, how many times does 75 go into 240? That's going to be 3 times. So that'll be 3. And then 3 times 75 is 225. So we get 15. All right, so there's a remainder. So what do? We put another 0 so we could bring down the 0. How many times does 75 go into 150? Goes in twice. Goes in exactly, and so we're done. Our answer is 3.2. So the answer to this problem is 3.2. Now, how would you check? You have to check the original problem, right? The original problem was 0.75 into 2.4. So what you're really checking is, what is 3.2 times 0.75? So that's what you have to multiply. And you can use any method you want for multiplying, and you should end up with 2.4 for your answer. So it does check. All right, so we've only done a few problems here. I'm going to show you how you can use this to your advantage. This idea of multiplying the numerator and denominator, moving decimals over, etc. For problems that have, when you're dividing by numbers like 30 or 40, etc. So that'll be on the next video. We'll do some more problems, dividing by decimals and dividing by numbers that have extra zeros in them. On this video, I show you how to divide decimals by whole numbers and round the answers when necessary to the nearest hundredth. So we do the following 5 problems on this video. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.